and welcome to a new episode of our Tech Talk series. This is the second Tech Talk on our topic AV in the Loop. Last time we talked about the complexity of testing autonomous driving functions and also about the safety aspects. Today we want to give you some more practical insights. I'm joined today by two experts on autonomous driving, Lisa Schudi, who has already joined us last time, and Martin Herrmann. Welcome to both of you.
Thanks again.
Thanks for having us.
So as we heard last time, OEMs and suppliers need different environments when testing autonomous driving functions, resulting in different use cases. Today we want to look at the different hardware-in-the-loop setups that are required for testing. Martin, could you please tell us what the most common HIL setup is?
Well, when it comes to AV in the loop, the most common setup is end-to-end testing. That means we test an autonomous driving functions from the beginning, the perception system, all the way to the motion control. And we now have to fool this ECU to really believe that it's not in a lab environment, but in an actual car.
Mm-hmm. And how do we fool the ECU?
Well, we take a look at the inputs and outputs of the system. So on the input side, we provide the sensor signals, we provide rest bus simulation, and on the output side, we take the control values for brake, propulsion, and steering, and feed it into the vehicle model, which then moves through the scene.
So which components are needed for the HIL setup?
Let's take a look at our example system. So here we have the most important components, the XPEC for real-time system, for vehicle dynamics, traffic, and rest bus simulation. Then we have our scalable sense compute platform for simulation of the physical sensor models for camera, radar, and LiDAR. And these signals are then sent to the sense inject, where they are prepared and serialized to be injected into the system under test.
Can you give us a live demo?
Sure. We have prepared a highway scenario for our vehicle equipped with multiple sensors and a highway pilot. So here we are on our highway with our autonomous vehicle. We are simulating a complete sensor set on 8 GPUs. Of these 8 GPUs, one GPU is used for the visualization on the host PC, and 7 are used for the complex sensor set, for 7 8-megapixel cameras, 4 2-megapixel cameras, and 1 Velodyne LiDAR. In addition to that, 4 radar sensors are simulated on the CPU, as they are using a phenomenological model in this case. So you can see, we can simulate a complete complex sensor suite of an autonomous vehicle in real time using GPU parallelization.
Martin, your HIL setup focused on the parallelization of sensor simulation. This is a rather common use case for AV simulation. Lisa, maybe you can show us a more unique use case.
Yes, of course. So another HIL setup that we are actually using at the moment focuses not only on the GPU synchronization and parallelization, but also on the CPU parallelization.
Let's take a closer look into this. When we're talking about the parallelization of GPUs, we usually see that a lot of sensors are being parallelized on a GPU server. The server is connected to the truck maker on our real-time hardware XPEC4 via our sense compute system. In our new HIL setup, the information from the simulation and the sensor data is then sent to a stack of XPEC4 systems, the number of which depends on the amount of data that needs to be calculated in each use case. Within the stack, we are able to parallelize the CPUs and thus are able to avoid the bottleneck on the CPU side. The combined message of the simulation and the sensors is then sent to the unit on our test.
Lisa, can you show us a live demo for this specific use case as well?
Of course. So I brought with me today a scenario from our HT database, which is San Francisco. And you will see once the movie and X simulation is started that there are a lot of objects lying around on the street. On the side, you can see different bicycles, for example, but also trash. On the other side, you see the tram tracks. And from all these different objects, there are information sent via the RSI sensors inside of the simulation to our ECUs. And we don't only have with our HIL setup here the camera side, but also the radar and LiDAR simulation of the sensors.
Thanks for showing us, Lisa.
You're welcome.
And that's exactly what it's all about. We build tailor-made solutions according to the requirements of you, our customers. So if you're interested in an AV in the loop test system, please get in touch with us.
Martin, Lisa, thanks for joining me on our Tech Talk today. It was a pleasure having you both here. So that's it for today. If you have any questions or if you would like to explain us your use cases in the comments below, feel free to do so. And see you next time.